Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studio. Thanks for watching. This video is a special one. It's an awesome one because it's suggested by one of my viewers. This is from Jyhina. I hope I said that right. It's J-Y-H-I-N-A. All lowercase letters. Anyway, they wanted to see the best draft picks per team, excluding first rounders. What I did was I modified this a little bit. And so what I'm doing here, this video is the best diamonds in the rough per team. So what's a diamond in the rough? Well, I think a diamond in the rough is a player that's drafted 100th or later. That's just sort of an arbitrary number that I gave. I think that by then you're in the fifth round in most cases, and you're getting deep into the draft. So if you were drafted 100th or later, I'm saying that's a diamond in the rough. And so this video will include past histories of teams so I can get as much of a comprehensive look at each team as I can. So we're going to see Hartford Whalers, Quebec Nordiques, the old Winnipeg Jets, Atlanta Thrashers, you name it, this is in it. So this video, again, suggested by Jyhina, boy, I really hope I said that right, is the best diamond in the rough draft picks per NHL team. Let's go. Anaheim selected Sammy Vatanen, 106th overall in 2009. Still early in his NHL career, Vatanen has already established himself as a top 4D man. His first three seasons really displayed what a diamond in the rough the Ducks had found. However, he has struggled since the start of the 2016-17 season and has since been traded. Thomas Steen was drafted 103rd overall in 1979 by the Winnipeg Jets. Boy, it's too bad that Thomas Steen is probably forgotten by a lot of hockey fans today. I think he was a great player. The slight centerman from Grums, Sweden, I hope I said that right too, played his entire 14-year career in Winnipeg. More than half the time, the Jets were under 500, but Steen could always be counted on for around 65 points and play in all situations. The Bruins selected Don Sweeney, 166th overall in 1984. For history as long as Boston's, I was surprised the best diamond in the rough I could find was Don Sweeney. Sweeney did play over 1,100 NHL games, so he certainly enjoyed a nice long career, but that's far from being a diamond. Sweeney's best season was 34 points. The Buffalo Sabres found Ryan Miller 138th overall in 1999. Without question, the most successful goalie taken in the 09 draft, Ryan Miller has 7 30-win seasons and won the Vezina in 2010. In the 06-07 season, Miller was 40-16-6. Currently, Miller is well within shooting distance of John Van Beesbrouck's wins record for U.S.-born NHL goalies. Brett Hull was taken 117th overall by the Calgary Flames in 1984. It's hard to point out a better shooter than Brett Hull. Three times he led the league in goals. Brett is a five-time 50-goal scorer who averaged 44 goals a year over his 16 full seasons. Only Gretzky, Howe, and Jagr have scored more regular season goals in the NHL than the Golden Brett. Carolina drafted Craig Adams, 223rd overall in 1996. Carolina was probably the hardest team to pick for this list. I picked Craig Adams because he did play over 900 games in the NHL. Yeah, he only scored 160 points, but he must have been doing something well to stay in the lineup for 14 years and win two Stanley Cups. The first one in 06 with the Hurricanes and then in 09 with the Penguins. Chicago drafted Dominic Hasek, 199th overall in 1983. 1983 is quite possibly the greatest draft year in NHL history. Hasek didn't even know he was drafted when Chicago took him in the 10th round that year. 11 years later, Dominic Hasek was the best goalie in the world. Anyone who wants to argue that Hasek and his 6 Vezina trophies and 2 MVPs is the greatest goalie of all time has a pretty solid case. The Quebec Nordiques drafted Valery Kamensky, 129th overall in 1988. Kamensky didn't play in the NHL until he was 25, but still played 11 years in North America with 4 20-goal seasons. In 95-96, Kamensky scored a career-high 38 goals and 85 points and won the Stanley Cup with Colorado. Columbus drafted Cam Atkinson, 157th overall in 2008. Only Steven Stamkos and Jordan Eberle have a higher goals per game average from the 08 draft. That's higher than Atkinson's. Cam improved his goal totals 5 years in a row, netting a career-high 35 in 2016-17. Jamie Benn was drafted 129th overall in 2007 by the Dallas Stars. That 07 draft was a pretty darn good draft here, if you ask me. Jamie Benn is the second highest scoring player to come out of that draft so far. The 7-time 20-goal scorer is a 3-time All-Star and winner of the 2014-15 Art Ross. Detroit chose Pavel Datsyuk 171st overall in 1998. During his best 6-year period there, Datsyuk averaged 28 goals and 84 points a year, but there was so much more to him than that. Datsyuk was brilliant, with and without the puck. So many of his plays were magic. He won the Selke 3 times, the Lady Bing 4 times, and was a Hart Trophy finalist in 2009. In 1993, the Edmonton Oilers chose Miro Chatan, 111th overall. For a 10-year period there, Miro Chatan averaged 30 goals a season. He was remarkably consistent. Chatan scored a career-high 40 in 98-99, and Buffalo might have won the Cup that year if he didn't miss half the playoffs. Chatan eventually did win the Stanley Cup with Pittsburgh in 2009. At 117th overall in 1998, Florida went with Yaroslav Spatchek. I'm not saying Spatchek is a bad player, but if he's the best diamond in the rough the Panthers have ever found, then there's just another clue about Florida's lame hockey history. Spatchek played over 800 games across 13 years for 7 teams. I wonder how many mortgages he had. LA went with Luc Robitaille, 171st overall in 1984. Only one player from the 84 draft outscored Luc Robitaille in their careers, and he was taken first overall. The 87 Calder winner was a 13-time 30-goal scorer, even scoring 30 and more into his early to mid-30s. Robitaille was an 8-time All-Star and scored a career-high 63 goals and 125 points in 92-93. Minnesota chose Eric Halla, 182nd overall in 2009. First player taken in the final round of the 09 draft, Halla is a good utility player with a knack for clutch scoring. Over a fifth of his career goals are game winners, and he was plus 21 with 34 points in 2015-16. Montreal drafted Andre Markov, 162nd overall in 1998, and for a dozen years, Markov was the Habs' top defenseman. Regularly playing 25 minutes a game all season and in all situations, Markov topped 40 points in a season 7 times. He produced a career-high 64 points in 08-09. The Nashville Predators drafted goalie Pekka Rinne, 258th overall in 2004. Only 2 goalies were taken after Rinne was drafted that year, but no goalie has posted better numbers than Rinne from the 04 draft. Rinne has 6 30-win seasons. He led the league in wins, shots, and saves during the 2011-12 season. He's a 3-time Vezina finalist, and you name it, Rinne is at the top of the Preds franchise leaderboard. New Jersey drafted Steve Sullivan, 233rd overall in 1994. Small guys in the early 90s didn't stand a chance. Sullivan put out 113 points in 64 games for the Greyhounds in his draft year and didn't get called until the 9th round. Sullivan played for 6 teams over his 16-year career and had 8 20-goal seasons. His 34-goal and 75-point 2000-2001 season was his best. The New York Islanders chose Marty MacInnis, 163rd overall in 1988. This is seriously another reflection of how bad the Islanders have drafted over the years. I'm not saying Marty MacInnis is a bad NHLer, but he was never an all-star. In 12 seasons, his best year was 93-94 when he scored 25 goals and 56 points. The New York Rangers drafted Henrik Lundqvist, 205th overall in 2000. I've been getting creamed in the comments on how I'm pronouncing his name, so Henrik Lundqvist for sure. The 2000 draft will always be remembered because it was the first time a goalie was selected first overall. However, it's actually the 22nd goalie drafted that year that became the best. Lundqvist is a future Hall of Famer and was taken in the 7th round in 2000. He has since recorded 11 30-win seasons and won the Vezina in 2012. Daniel Alfredsson was drafted by the Ottawa Senators 133rd overall in 1994, the best player in team history because he owns all the team records by a long shot. Alfredsson won the Calder and went on to score 20 or more goals 13 of his 18 NHL seasons. After the lockout, Alfie cranked out 43 goals and 103 points, both career highs. Here's a nice throwback one. Rick Tocchet was drafted by Philadelphia, 121st overall in 1983. One of the fiercest players ever, Tocchet was a force all over the ice and could beat you both with his body or his offense. You don't see guys like Tocchet anymore in the NHL. He scored 48 goals and 109 points in 92-93 while racking up 252 penalty minutes. Ryan Malone was drafted by the Penguins, 115th overall in 1999. The hard-shooting left winger from Pittsburgh played four seasons for his hometown team. Malone was a six-time 20-goal scorer and had a career-best 27 in 07-08. Doug Gilmour was drafted by the St. Louis Blues, 134th overall in 1982. 8 times Dougie finished in the top 10 in voting for the Selke, winning it in 1993. From the start of the 86-87 season to the end of the 93-94 year, Gilmour averaged 97 points a season, including 3 100-plus point campaigns and a career-high 127 points in 92-93. San Jose drafted Evgeny Nabokov, 219th overall in 1994. The 2001 Rookie of the Year was the 22nd goalie taken in that draft year, but became one of the best. Nabokov had 6 30-win seasons, and that includes his incredible 46-win 07-08 season. Nabby's 353 career wins are the most ever by a Russian-born NHLer. Tampa Bay went with Pavel Kabina, 179th overall in 1996. The 260-pound Czech monster had a bullet shot that helped him score a career-high 17 goals for the Lightning in 03-04. Later, Kabina had back-to-back 40-point seasons in Toronto in 08 and 09. Speaking of the Maple Leafs, Toronto chose Thomas Caberle, 204th overall in 1996. Quietly over 10 years, Caberle had a nice career in Toronto. 8 times he scored more than 40 points, including a career-high 67 in 05-06. Leaf fans will remember Caberle for never shooting. His career high was only 163 shots on goal in a season. To put that into perspective, Brent Burns led all shooters in 2016-17 with 320 shots on goal. Pavel Bure was drafted in the 6th round by the Vancouver Canucks in 1989, 113th overall, and Bure was just pure speed and adrenaline. Bure was one of the most exciting players ever in NHL history. His speed and his shot were just too much for the NHL during his 12-year career. Bure was 3 career goals short of having 4 60-goal seasons. Amazing! I think Pavel Bure is the greatest Vancouver Canuck of all time. Most fun to watch, that's for sure. Well, just for some fun and real quick, Vegas Golden Knights drafted 5 players in 2017 in the 5th round or later. So far, none of them have played in the NHL, but I've got my money on Nick Campoli because those Tier 2 kids don't get enough credit, especially in Ontario. Washington chose Peter Bondra, 156th overall in 1990. Well before anyone had heard the name Alexander Ovechkin, there was Peter Bondra. For over a dozen years, Caps fans could always count on Bondra, a 7-time 30-goal scorer, which includes 2 50-goal seasons. His 52 goals in 1998 led the league. Bondra finished with 503 career goals. In 2003, the Atlanta Thrashers chose defenseman Tobias Enstrom, 239th overall. Well, we all know that 03 draft was stacked, and Toby Enstrom helps prove it. He's part of nearly 40 players from that class year to play over 600 NHL games. Enstrom has spent his entire career with the Atlanta Winnipeg franchise. He had a career-high 51 points in 2010-11. I hope you enjoyed that Diamonds in the Rough pick suggested by YouTube viewer Jyhina. Man, I hope I got that name right. It's the last name comment I'm going to make about this, I promise. Some teams were really difficult to choose, as is with any time I'm doing these lists, these videos that include all 30 or 31 teams. I mean, Boston really surprised me with Don Sweeney, Carolina with Craig Adams. Those are a couple of tough picks. Winnipeg and Atlanta, again, Toby Enstrom is a good hockey player, but not really what I'd call diamond in the rough, but players I had to choose given the stipulation. Other teams, really easy to pick. I mean, the New York Rangers, everyone knows by now that Henrik Lundqvist was drafted 205th overall in 2000. That's just one of those amazing picks that'll go down in history. I would say that Calgary choosing Brett Hull is probably the best diamond in the rough out of all the teams and all the picks. When you're the fourth highest scoring goal scorer in NHL history, that is a big, bright, shiny diamond in the rough, I'll tell ya. And unfortunately for Calgary, they let that diamond go when he was still a coal. What do you think were some of the best diamonds in the rough? Who would you say is the biggest find, the biggest diamond in the rough? Do you agree with Brett Hull, or would you say somebody else? One pick I might change if I was going to go back and do this, another one that I struggled with, was Anaheim. I didn't choose a lot of players that were newer to their careers. I went with Sammy Vatanen for the Ducks. I could have gone with P.A. Parenteau. What do you think about that one? Should I have gone with Parenteau, or should I stick with Vatanen? Let me know in the comments below. If you have any suggestions for future videos, let me know about them. Write them in the comments and I'll get back to you for sure. Again, another thanks to Jyhina for suggesting this list. It was a lot of fun to create and I hope you enjoyed watching it. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.